Okay, in this final part, we're going to look at production, mass customization in production strategy. So far, we've looked, let's go back to our original slide, we've looked at craft production, the efficiencies gained through mass production, and then minimizing waste to give us a lean production strategy. And finally, we'll have a look at what is currently contemporary practice in many industries around the world, and that is mass customization. So different product configurations contain a majority of shared component and features to accommodate volume and variety. So imagine if we could make one sleeve that we could apply, so we'd mass produce one sleeve and we could apply it to 15 different garments. There'd be great savings in being able to have one specific process to make this one sleeve, but yet end up with different garments. And this is all possible through the process of postponement. So there's a couple of really good websites which can show you this, but I think Nike's the first one, Nike USA, not Australia. But no, their website's down at the moment, which is unbelievable. But what it allows you to do is to select a shoe, and then you can customize it by changing the colors, the materials used, placing your own name on it, for instance. But I'll show you another one which also gives you the general idea. Let's say we want to buy a dress and we want this green one, and we can start to customize it by choosing our own shoulder width, chest, bust, under bust, hip, etc. So every time I'm selecting this, what I'm putting in a very specific order to a factory to make this garment, and then height, obviously. So you end up, well, it's not finished, but the idea is that the factory has already made most of these components. Indeed, they might have actually even cut the pieces. And when I place my order, all that's required is the selection of certain pieces, certain sizes, and the assembly of them, or the sewing of it. So if we take the height, then these pieces have already been cut for these specific heights. I'll just show you visually what that's going to look like. Let's go to our Lee Agile system. So here we've got a manufacturer. They've got this roll of green fabric. They've cut all the pieces for varying sizes, moved it through the production facility, and they've stopped here. So you've got a room with lots of boxes, lots of pieces of fabric. And when I place my order for the green point, then the factory worker will go and select the appropriate pieces of fabric and assemble a garment. That's what we call this decoupling point. And then off goes my garment to be sent to me. What this fundamentally does, it combines the best of two systems. It combines the best of, let me go back, customization or craft production specific to the individual's needs, and mass production. And so you can end up with a wide variety of products coming out of a single factory. This gives us an agile or very flexible supply chain. A supply chain that is driven by demand of customers. So if a customer doesn't order the dress, the pieces of fabric already cut just sit in a distribution center waiting. And you're not wasting resources assembling the garment, sending it out to retail stores and hoping they buy it, particularly when you have to take into account size ratios, different colors, etc. Much more efficient system. So it allows for maximum flexibility, incorporating this concept of postponement strategy, which is the yellow circle, if you like. Another way to visually represent this is before and after standardization. So if you take a product like in the car industry, I'm not sure if it's... Oh yeah, here's a news article from 2011, but there was criticism targeted towards the Audi car maker, because a lot of the components in these very expensive European cars come from VW, Volkswagen, the parent company, which are not expensive European cars. So what the strategy was is the managers decided, well, how many of these components of this car can we actually share between the two brands? So it could be, for instance, the wheels, maybe the light bulbs in there, the indicators might all be shared. And the advantage of that is you have this sort of arrangement where, imagine this is a factory, these are the components, and so from, if we're going to make wheels, let's have one factory, it makes all the wheels for many different cars, and then at this point the wheels would then go off to be tailor-made. So perhaps putting the badge on the side of the wheel would be for Audi, would be one process, for VW would be another process, and then other components are added. So you end up with one, two, three, four different cars or four different models that share the same wheel. Now, before standardization, you basically had to start with one factory producing one wheel for, say, a luxury car, and producing a different wheel for a smaller car, for instance, or a cheaper car. So fundamentally, you had these two processes were sort of reduced to one, meaning you need less material, less workers, less machinery, and reducing costs. So this idea of looking at ways in which you can share components is important, and at the same time being flexible in your ability to sort of mix and match to get a customized product, means that we're now in an era of being able to almost order a garment that you want, specific for you, but at prices that reflect a mass-produced garment. Okay, so what we looked at, just to recap, finally, we've got a corporate strategy has to be directly in line with the logistics strategy, because they need to work on the same basis. The question becomes, what sort of production method do we want for our garments? Craft, mass production, lean production, or mass customization? And then, how do we make sure we can minimize each of those processes? So whether we look at the lean production or agility in our supply chain to do so. Okay, there'll be another video, short one, just to give you a little brief rundown on the test, which is next week, in the lecture times. So it's a 1 hour test, but as I say, I'll give you more details in the next video.